Sarastro, 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 Scene changes to the court of Sarastro, and what we see first suggests that all the Queen of the Night has said about his evil is justified. The Moorish slave Monostatos, Heinz Zednik, is dragging on Pamina, Patricia Schuman, to have his way with her. But the appearance of Papageno interrupts things, and Monostatos and he are terrified of each other.
Yeah, boy.
Papageno tells Pamina not to be afraid and compares her carefully with the portrait given to Tamino. He tells her that Tamino is on his way to rescue her. He's fallen in love with her. In a duet, Papageno and Pamina sing of the joys of love, and nothing better epitomizes Harnoncourt's approach to this opera than the touching, slow, and utterly free treatment of this famous duet.
Yeah.
first act finale of Die Zauberflöte is set in a grove with three temples dedicated to reason, nature, and wisdom. The three boys lead Tamino in, and he seeks entry to each temple in turn. The speaker, a priest of the temple, sung by Hermann Pry, emerges to tell him that Sarastro is a force for good. The Queen of the Night is enthralled to evil and darkness. Voices off tell him that Pamina lives. He joyfully takes the magic flute and plays. Wild animals gather round. The sound of his flute is answered by Papageno's pipe. Pamina and Papageno are escaping, but just as they appear, they're surrounded by Monostatos and his henchmen. All seems lost, but Papageno plays his magic bells, and their captors all dance off, singing merrily sotto voce. With fanfares, the music moves into a stern C major, and Sarastro's return from the hunt is imminent. What shall we say, worries Papageno. And Pamina, in a phrase which Mozart and Harnoncourt make a central declaration of the opera, she declares, the truth, even if we are deep. Sarastro, sung by Matti Salminen, appears. Pamina begs forgiveness, and he punishes Monostatos. In the hurly-burly, Tamino and Pamina see and recognise each other, but they're immediately separated. Sarastro sends Tamino and Papageno off to undergo their trials. In a frenetic chorus, the priests praise Sarastro's wisdom. First, though, the three boys. This path leads to your goal. Be constant and patient.
Pamina retten! Schwestern, ist mir Pflicht.
Sarastro dir, die Absicht sei. zu klar. Frisst ist der Räuber und erbarmen, Pamina aus der Mutter Armen.
Ja, Jüngling, was du sagst, ist wahr.
Wo ist sie? Sie uns geraubt.
Man opferte vielleicht wie schon.
Hier bist du sagen, teurer Sohn, bis jetzt und mir noch nicht erlaubt.
Erklär dies Rätsel, täusch mich nicht.
Die Zunge bindet Heim und Pflicht.
Wann also
Holde Flöte durch dein Spiel.
Pamina.
La 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 la
dir deine Wien sprechen.
Wegen dieser Blüten, bedenkt, der Name ist
The end of Act One of Mozart's Die Zauberflöte in the Vienna State Opera production conducted by Nikolaus Harnoncourt. Well, when I talked to Harnoncourt recently about this performance, I brought up some of the extreme speeds in that first act. Very fast in that final chorus, very slow in the Pamina and Papageno duet. And I asked him if he could explain his choices of tempo.
These are places where I have to think, why did Mozart write this and not anything else? There are two pieces of very similar rhythm, that is the duet of Pamina and Papageno and the aria of Pamina. And the one is in Andante, the aria of Pamina, and the duet is in Andantino. There is no other difference. 6/8 meter and both the rhythm pam, 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 which is a imitation of heart beating. Now, I know that Andantino is for Mozart slower than Andante is. And he must have had a reason to write this piece in a bit slower tempo. Now I have tried to find out anything which I could about the use of tempi with Mozart. And I found out that Mozart was so accurate. He writes about 55 different tempos in one opera. And when he's not sure that the performer will catch the right tempo, he scratches out what he wrote and writes another tempo. So he says also in his letters, the most important thing is to find the right tempo. So it was very important for him. And so it must be very important for me to find out what he meant. And when I see that he changes, for instance, Allegro assai into molto allegro. I don't know of any modern musician who knows what is fast and what is slower. Allegro assai, one would say it's a very fast allegro, and allegro molto is a very fast allegro too. So Mozart's will to differentiate must be much sharper than what we have. And when he uses andante, he very frequently writes andante piuttosto allegretto. That means don't be too slow. Don't be too slow. When you come to his andantes, you find out don't be too slow. When he wants andante slower, he and in the direction to the adagio, but not the real adagio, then he writes andantino. And most of the andantino pieces of Mozart are sad pieces or very romantic pieces. To ensure if andantino is really slower than andante, I had to go deeply into the question and found out that in the middle of Beethoven's life in Vienna, the andantino changed to be a faster tempo than andante, because at that time andante was thought to be a slow tempo. As long as andante is a fast tempo, andantino is slower, a bit andante, and più andante means faster. More andante means faster. Who loves each other? It's a very special piece. And I think it is a great romantic duet of great tenderness. And on the other hand, I think that the aria of Pamina has a certain restlessness in it. And if it is sung beautiful, the tempo is all right. I would never choose a tempo just naked, just the tempo. It has to do with who sings it and who plays and how great is the room. But if I have the singers and I have the room which carries in the right way, I choose a tempo just because of my conviction. The other thing you mentioned was the presto at the end of the first act. It's presto alla breve. That is the fastest tempo Mozart used in this piece. What can that mean? It's very a complicated thing. Sarastro is introduced as a very bad man. But even when he is within his own world, it's difficult to find him sympathetic, because you see him first coming home from hunting. And a hunter is not a man who calms down everything and who is a friend of peace. He has a lot of slaves everywhere, chains. His way to punish is to beat people. His words are very solemn and are very friendly, but his behavior is not nice. And he always frightens the people when he say, I don't know if you come out living out of this test. So it's not a really nice atmosphere there. And when the chorus sings, wenn Tugend und Gerechtigkeit der großen Pfad mit Ruhm bestreut. And he repeats, mit Ruhm bestreut, mit Ruhm bestreut. If you look just at the text, you would compose Allegro like a Kyrie eleison or Gloria in Excelsis Deo or something like that. If it is speeded up like Mozart does in this case, I hear a great amount of irony, and I hear that he doesn't believe that they believe what they say. And when they repeat mit Ruhm bestreut, mit Ruhm bestreut, it is funny. It is funny, and it is as if they had to sing a given text to greet him and to praise him, but they don't really believe in what they say. And I cannot see another reason for that. And so I have to do it in that tempo. If I do it slower, I crucify the demand of Mozart, and I make something which is meant ironic, I make it serious. And so I do two faults.
Do you see inconsistencies and problems in the text of the opera?
Or? No. I think it's a very good text, and it has no inconsistency. It's very good. Almost all critics and some musicians and some directors think that the first act and the second act are not of the same spirit, and Mozart starts to write for a good Queen of the Night and a bad Sarastro, and he changes to be bad queen of the night in the good Sarastro. But I think it's just a normal divorcing problem. If you know a couple in divorce and you speak with him, he will explain very convincingly that she is a devil, and you will say, yes, I understand, you could not live with this witch. And if 1 hour later you speak with her, she will convince you, even if you are convinced already 1 hour before by him, she will convince you that it's upside down and that he is an absolute criminal, and she will explain her view of the case. And so it's very human to be introduced in a situation, and Tamino is brainwashed by the Queen of the Night to be a partisan for her view of the struggle. And when he meets the world of Sarastro, he is again brainwashed, and he is convinced by this very, very, very complicated and very sly Sprecher and Sarastro himself that what he has learned with the Queen of the Night was wrong, and that the other side of the divorcing couple is the right one. I think this is very natural.
But surely Mozart takes a view on this, doesn't he? Because in the Queen of the Night's music he shows us an element of parody or irony, whereas in Sarastro's aria it is suddenly, isn't it, absolutely serious?
This is one of the greatest specialities of Mozart. He is not judging if a person who says something is a good or bad person. When a bad man speaks about peace, good things, the things he says are very good, but he still is a bad man, and you cannot hear that in the way he speaks about peace. I think it's the most naturalistic and most refined way a composer can compose.
Nikolaus Harnoncourt on the human world of Mozart's Zauberflöte. Well, his interpretation, which will shortly be issued on record with a rather different cast, certainly proved controversial in Vienna, as you'll hear from some barracking at the start of this second act. It opens with a serene march for the priests. Then Sarastro asks their opinion of Tamino's worth. They signal their approval in Masonic chords which echo the opera's overture, and Sarastro invokes the gods, Isis and Osiris.
Thank you. Weisheit und Tempel eingeweiht und ihrer der großen Götter Osiris und Isis. Tamino, ein Königssohn, will seinen nächtlichen Schleier von sich reißen und ins Heiligtum des größten Lichtes blicken. Ihm freundschaftlich die Hand zu bieten, sei heute unsere Pflicht.
Ja, besitzt Tugend.
Tugend.
Auch Verschwiegenheit?
Verschwiegenheit.
Ist er wohltätig?
Er ist wohltätig. Pamina, das tugendhafte Mädchen haben die Götter dem holden Jüngling bestimmt. Dies ist der Grund, warum ich sie der stolzen Mutter entrisse. Das Weib, pünktlich groß zu sein, hoffentlich Blendwerk und Arbeitslaufen das Volk zu berücken und unseren festen Tempelbau zu zerstören. Allein, das soll sie nicht. Tamino selbst soll ihn mit uns befestigen.
Großer Sarastro, verzeih, dass ich so frei bin, dir meine Zweifel zu eröffnen. Wird Tamino die harten Prüfungen bestehen? Er ist Prinz.
Noch mehr. Er ist Mensch.
Und wenn er stirbt?
Dann ist er Osiris und Isis gegeben und wird der Götterfreuden früher fühlen als wir. Haltet ihr ihn für würdig, so folgt meinem Beispiel. Tamino mit seinem Reisegefährten in den Vorhof des Tempels ein. Mögen Sie die Macht der Götter erkennen lernen.
Thank you.
Tamino and Papageno are brought in by the priests to face their trials. A reluctant Papageno is encouraged by the promise of a Papagena at the end of it all, but the priests warn the pair to beware of the wiles of women and to remain silent. The three ladies appear, and there's another quintet, very different from that in Act One. That one ended in harmony. This ends in violent dissonance, as they try to turn Tamino against Sarastro. On the chord of a diminished seventh, thunder breaks and the ladies are whisked away. Papageno comments, "Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear," and the music collapses.
Thank you.
Now back to Sarastro's court and to a picturesque garden where Monostatos is still lusting after Pamina.
Alles Winter, liebe Freude, schneebend, händen, fest und küssen. Ich soll die Liebe weiter sein, du schwarzer Hässling, weil du schwarzer Hässling. Ist mir denn mein Herz gegeben? Bin Fleisch und Blut, bin Fleisch und Blut.
Monostatos is driven away by the sudden arrival of the Queen of the Night, who's come to see her daughter. She tries to persuade Pamina of Sarastro's evil and says she must kill him. In another fiercely virtuosic aria, the Queen of the Night threatens to curse Pamina if she refuses.
Thank you.
Sarastro tells Pamina not to fear. He knows the evil intentions of the Queen. The music softens into E major, and he reassures her that within these sacred portals, revenge is unknown. Enemies are forgiven. Tamino and Papageno undergo the test of remaining silent. Tamino does better than Papageno. As his reward, the three boys appear at Sarastro's command, bearing lavish food and drink, and giving them back the magic bells and the magic flute. Then we hear Tamino musing on his flute, rather an accomplished solo this, and Pamina approaches him.
Thank you. No, my name is Feinsen.
Der Blaise.
Herr Sarasso führt eine gute Küche. Matthias will ich schon schweigen. Ob auch der Keller so bestellt ist. Das ist besser, Wein.
Du hier, Gott sei Dank, ich höre deine Klöte und hier bin ich.
But Tamino must remain silent, and Pamina thinks he has deserted her. She laments in a G minor aria, done here with the greatest freedom. At the close, it almost disappears into silence.
Thank you.
Sarastro and the priests process solemnly in, and Sarastro declares that Tamino and Pamina must part. In a trio, the three of them are united in accepting this fate, but Tamino and Pamina look forward to being reunited. O golden repose, return.
Dein Betragen war bisher männlich und gelassen. Nun hast du noch zwei gefährliche Wege zu wandern. Man bringe Pamina.
Mögen sie bewahren, sei
Meanwhile, Papageno has been left on his own. He decides he can forego enlightenment if only he has a good glass of wine, which is promptly provided. His mind turns to another serious lack, that of a wife, and his magic bells help him to conjure up a rather wistful vision.
Papagino sie, wo du ein ganzes Teufel wer sie dich für mich? Dann schmecken wir trinken und essen, dann könnt ich mit Würfen nicht messen. Es leben als Weiber nicht rein, wie will ich die Jung sein. Dann könnt ich mit Würfen nicht messen. Es leben als Weiber nicht rein, wie will ich die Jung sein. Im will die Jung sein. Ein Mädchen oder beiden sind Papagino sie. Ein sanftes Keuchen, wer sieht bei für mich? Ach, kann ich denn keiner von allen den reichsten Mädchen gefallen? Wir beide dir nur
beide gefallen. Helf eine mir nur heraus, sonst gräb ich mich wahrlich zu Tod. Mich wahrlich zu Tod. Mich wahrlich zu Tod. Ein Mädchen oder beiden wünscht Papagino sie, und du ein sanftes Träumchen, wer sieht ein für mich.
Finale of Die Zauberflöte opens, as did the first, with the three boys. Back in the opera's home key of E-flat, they hymn the imminent rising of the sun, which will herald the triumph of truth and wisdom. But once again, the music shifts into an intense C minor as Pamina enters, calling on her mother and resolved on suicide. In the most strongly chromatic music of the opera, recalling the G minor of her earlier aria, Pamina embraces death. But the boys intervene and tell her that Tamino is suffering now for her. She relents and goes to help him. The scene changes to that of the trials by fire and water. In a mysterious Baroque-style chorale prelude, two armed men declaim the moral that whoever undergoes the trials will be purified. Tamino is brought in, and then Pamina too is allowed to enter. At this point, Harnoncourt almost stops the rhythmic movement completely. The music shifts into a luminous F major, and the couple acknowledge each other with piercing clarity. Together, they will have the strength to face the trials. With the flute playing, and with utterly simple harmonies, they pass first through the fire, and then through the water. A choral outburst celebrates their triumph. Meanwhile, Papageno too is determined to commit suicide. No wife has appeared. The boys again intervene and remind him of his magic bells. When he plays them, he's rewarded with his sprightly bride, Papagena, sung by Eva Lind. They envisage their future life together, which will be probably unenlightened, but certainly cheerful. There's a last flurry of C minor, as an alliance between the Queen of the Night, the Three Ladies, and Monostatos makes a desperate attempt to overthrow Sarastro. But it's no use. Thunder and tempest overwhelm them, and the harmony of the opera's home key of E-flat returns. We're in the Temple of the Sun, ideally, in this Vienna State Opera production, in a stage created as one giant circle, framed within a sun, and Sarastro hymns its power. The sun's rays drive out the night. And so the second act finale ends with the fulfillment of that hope of which the three boys now sing. Soon the wise man will triumph.
Thank you. Thank you. Mann zu hören, den Weg der Tugend fortzuwahren. Schließ mir der Schrecken Worten an. Ich frage froh den kühlen Raum. Was hör ich? Paminenstimme?
Ja, ja, das ist Paminenstimme. Wohl hier, nun kann sie mit mir gehen. Und Tränen aus mein Schicksal lehnen. Der laute Dunkle
Erlaubt
mir zu sprechen. Es ist, erlaubt mir zu sprechen.
Welch Glück, wenn wir uns hier sehen.
Voll
mit Frühen, Hand in Hand,
und Hand in Hand, in Fremden.
Allein das Nacht,
allein das Nacht, und ich nicht weit.
Ungeweint,
geweint,
ist
für
dich. Ihr werdet
werdet auch nach Mädchen hin. Ihr werdet auch nach Mädchen hin. Ich schlafe ganz als Zauberdinge. Ich schlafe ganz als Zauberdinge. Das Kind ist Glocken, wieder singe. Ich muss mein liebes Mädchen sehen. Ich muss mein liebes Mädchen sehen. Klingel, Klöckchen, klingel, schaff mein Mädchen hier. Klingel, Klöckchen, klingel, bring mein Weibchen her. Klingel, Klöckchen, klingel, schaff mein Mädchen her. Klingel, Klöckchen, klingel, schaff mein Mädchen her. Klingel, Klöckchen, klingel, bring mein Weibchen her. Bring sie hier, mein Mädchen hier, mein Weibchen her.
Er will, denk ich, muss meine Gattin sein.
Sie haben den Sohn.
lieber Feinde, lieber Feinde, lieber Feinde, von der Ehe, wo ich so fest geschrieben.
That's the end of Mozart's The Magic Flute, in a performance recorded at the Vienna State Opera last March. Tamino was sung by Jerry Hadley, and Pamina by Patricia Schuman. Papageno was Mikael, Melbye, Sarastro, Matti Salminen, and the Queen of the Night, Luciana, Serra. The three ladies were Joanna Borowska, Gabriele Sima, and Anna Gonda. Monostatos was Heinz, Zednik, Papagena Eva Lind. The speaker was Hermann Pry, the priest Waldemar Kmennt, and the two armed men Kurt Schreibmeier and Goran Simic. the three boys, were members of the Vienna Boys' Choir. The orchestra and the chorus were the Vienna State Operas, and the conductor was Nikolaus Harnoncourt.